onder die lezing halach is, dus Chazal Gebas, dus Tichas, Korra Avoide is, wat is de meaning of Tisha B'Av, how do we approach a whole Avoide, the Kinnis, the inspirations, and the Avoide Sayyid, and the fact that our chakras, of course, we didn't say Tachman, Korra Alai Moyed, Tisha B'Av is Zikri Moyed. But it's amazing halacha because Tachanun is the epitome of tzar, tefilas hapayim. If any day should have Tachanun should have been said, it definitely should have been a Tisha B'Av with the most tzar. What did Chazal mean, Nikri Moyed? Kiyimu, it's a time. It's a special day in the Klal Yisrael's life. It's a special day of the year that Klal Yisrael looks forward to in the Matzav of Golus. Yes, we look forward that it should be the Simcha V'Sasen and Tisha B'Av of Mashiach. But in the Matzav of Golus, we look forward to this day. It's a very special day. The Baba Musa explained the specialty of this day. What is the Madrega Tachtoina, the lowest Matzav? For a person, for Leidat Hashem, for a Klal Yisrael. For a person who says in the Shari Tshuva, in Shari Sheni, the Shari Tshuva speaks about a Madrega that he calls people. In Yadashim Tzadikim, Yishon, the Liboisom. There are people that tzaddikim yishar b'leibosam in their own hearts, tzaddikim yishar. There are people that their ways are righteous in their own eyes. V'liyidnu chelak b'atayra b'iskeyam v'mikerev libom, ends the paragraph, v'mikerev libom, Ovat Chesbon al Nafshon. A person that mikarev liboy from the depths of his heart, Ovat Chesbon al Nafshon. Not that Chesbon al Nafshon, he lost Chesbon. Ki goy oivad eitzoy seimo. The Pasuk says, they have no eitzoy. They don't know what it's all about. They're not chafing the matzah. The kama hin madrega tachtoyim. The lowest Madrega is, but it's Ovat Cheshmai. Goy Ovat Eitzai Seibo. The Yid loses the Cheshmai. He doesn't know where he's holding. He doesn't know what the emotion wants from us. He doesn't know what to look forward to. He doesn't know what to work on. He says to Rabbi Yehuda that that's the lowest Madrega. And the same will be a Klal Yisrael. Goy Ovat Eitzai Seibo. It was the Eitzai. I have to bring it out for myself and to share the dialogue. We go from Tehillim to Tehillim. We forget quickly from one to the other. So just easily from kidnapping to davening for missiles, to davening for soldiers, to terrorists. Shouldn't be attacking the Shalayim. The lawyer Rabbi said, what is the best that we can hope for in this matzah right now? I'm not a big politician. I can't tell you current events, but I can tell you that the government, the army should be able to do what they have to do as much as possible. Tunnels, whatever else they can take out, with at least casualties as possible, and it'll be shown for a while. For a while. How long will it be before the next time? Everyone knows. They'll only replenish the tunnels. The item are not stopping. It's a kaseda de kasinu. The sinna of this nation, international, against Klal Yisrael, is something which doesn't go away. It just finds ways to be violent and to appear in brutal and cruel ways. And if it's not in this part of the world, it's a different part of the world. And today, they're not afraid to raise their black flags and denounce Balyasol and do whatever they want, whatever they have the ability to do, the physical ability. Moshe Feinstein's Kohel Rocha used to say, as a good Yiddish can clap, God doesn't hit a Yiddish, his Balyasol's foil, only because he's lazy. That's what he used to say. And when the Rabbi Taka Maisa grew up on the east side, Moshe's area. The Mitaka, whatever it was, Shivabach or someone who gets hit by a guy, Moshe would say, the Emishna wants to remind us that we're in Golan, and we forget. We gave 5 to 11 and have this to accomplish and that to accomplish, whether it's Parnoso, and I want Nachas, and then just I go on in life. And today it's not a question of lazy, it's a question of just not having enough bullets, that's all. Model of Islam. It's just a question, it's when the next to him. That's the Mitzvah's environment. That's the way it is. You know that that's what it is. It's a temporary spike. That's what we're dominating for now. But for Lauren Cheshman, what's Tutsach dominant? What is happening over here? The whole world totally feels not obligated anymore by the Holocaust. They've lost the sense of shame in the international world. Maybe in Germany a little bit, they still have it, like this, for Laura Begansen. And now, a lot of me, and the Israel, and the Jewish, is all the same thing today. Vemesin, Avada, we know that everything is the Torah Seinu, obviously, everything is the Torah Seinu. We have to have a time to be displaying. What is happening? To make a cheshbon ha-nefesh, what the Eibishter wants of us. To make a cheshbon ha-nefesh, what we can do. And we chatzach, and we make that cheshbon ha-nefesh. That is for us a moyed. That is for us the best day. Moyed really means a meeting. It's a vat. It's a meeting with the Ribbono Shel Olam. And Klal Yisrael sits on the floor. And they say to themselves, what is going on? Where have we fallen? Where are we up to? From Churban Beis HaMikdash until today, look what we've gone through. When is it going to end? And they say, Ribbono Shel Olam, we want to end it. We want the Gula Shleima. That's what we really want to daven for. That's an Avodah day. When every Yid by himself makes a Cheshbon HaNefesh, it's a Avodah day. That's really what a Yid has to do. When Yid explains, when the Yid comes and he hears the Musa of the Chachamim, the Dibri Chachma of the Chachamim, and he's makabel to do what they say, it's as if he becomes a tzaddik overnight just by listening to the Chachamim and being makabel. See where that comes together. The seikin is to make a cheshbon ha-nefesh. To be inspired, to go away with something. To be Yashikoyah, Achyezer, the Bokhbar Bender, Azunzai, and all the Choshen, the speakers who are here are coming. It's a big schus, but it's a teyelis. It's a gemaldic teyelis. When people get together for that, that was the practice of the day. To come out from Dishalom with a clarity of thought and know what's happening. And chab demotzim. And know what we have, where we have to go and what we have to do. But as we have many, many brachas about the Geula. So the Shloah HaKadosh is brought down in the first year. I see that the Shloah HaKadosh says in the bracha of the Kav HaShoi for God world, Yesh L'Sabek Shoi Shoalenu Al Geula the bracha Reviyas Lama HaShoi HaKam. The Shloah says, what is the extra to Kav HaShoi for God world among the brachas of Geula? So he says like this, okay, Yesh L'Daz, Ki niskenu beis brachis eilo shnei golis. Echad golis aguf, hasheni golis aneshoma. We want to come from the Seder, from the Seder of Dusna Hashem, there were two golis in the Mitzrayim. There were two golis in the Haidika golis also, the golis aguf and the golis hanefesh. ובתחילו שאלנו על כל הסגוף, in the brachas of Shmonesse, denk aan Vanyenu, de andere brachas, die ken je gal, bij de Shoyne. De jachter kaak ze aan, maar hoe lang is aan de Shoma? En dit is hoe lang is aan de Shoma, is kan zijn de jachter, ja, kaak ze voor God, de geen zijn, de kaak zijn de jachter, daar we kan van zijn arbeid. Maar ja, Shoyfer, hij moet ze aan God, de geus, jullie we're talking about the final chaos, he says. The Zman HaYovel, the chaos of Klal Yisrael. This shofar gadol that we're speaking about, he says, is the Golus HaNeshama Beika. The Golus HaNeshama. The Shchintim Begalusa. The Shchina is in Golus. To make a cheshbon HaNefesh, the Klal Yisrael has to make just sharing with the Olam, the Tzairus, that the Ike is not the Tzairus HaGuf. The Tzairus HaGuf only reflect the Tzairus HaNefesh. Because the Baruch was being Ma'iros. As I go and get that club, is to remind the Ike that you're in Golus. Life is Beseder. If not, otherwise everything is fine. If everything is peaceful, fine. Back, welcome God, that's all to learn. First we'll go to seminary. I'll provide them my business. And everything will go back to normal. As I. The Marshal is reminding us that nothing is the same. The Torah is not what it should be. Just before we were worried about what's going to be with the Yeshivas and Eretz Yisrael, what's going to be with the Kollel. That was our first Machshava. Shmir Samit says, Baruch Hashem, Ach Shadara. But first of all, but the Dukim and Mitzvahs, how many drushes have to be heard about Shmir Saloshim and Shmir Sinayim and Tzniyus for the Noshim, that Klal Yisrael should be in the Sarah, that it should be the way it should be. And of course, what about all the Yidden that are not affiliated, the Kiddush Hashem that we have to make in order to be Makar of others? Shchintu Begalusa, when it's people's, the foremost Machshava, when they get up in the morning, is not Avedis Hashem, is not Kiddush Hashem. It's back to the Olam Hazeh that I have to continue in life. We have to continue in life. We have to know what's primary in life. Primary is Kiddush Hashem. Primary is the Golus HaNeshama. We should come back to the Mansev that we're really supposed to be. The Kavetzen Yachad, the Shlach Kodesh says, Gam Yesh Vemet, the Kavetzen Yachad, the Habulas HaShchina. The Kavetzen Yachad, the Sol HaYisrael, the Kutcher Brichu Chadu. Talking about Golus HaShchina, we're talking about Kavetzen Yachad, the Golus HaShchina. Kavetzen Yachad, who's the Yachad? Kutcher Brichu Sol HaYisrael. Us, the Peira. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the Kavetzen Yachad. We want to come together, all of us feeling good to Hashem together. In Avada, it's up to us. Shteza, it's up to us. Rabbi Gamliel Zecheinu Levracha was known to be a very outspoken, Meir and Klal Yisrael. Those who are familiar, Talmidim of Rabbi Gamliel, his Torah and his tapes, know that he didn't mince any words. Even he had a chibur which he was afraid to print in his lifetime. He didn't want to hurt people who went through the Holocaust. They printed it afterwards, not long ago, Divine Madness is called. Where he says, Avada, the Holocaust has been Hashemai from beginning to end. And then he speaks about Uvasa the Duns. He's speaking in his time. Who among us can say that the Holy Land would, Chas v'Shalom, not again be deprived of its Jewish inhabitants? We have a guarantee, he said. We have a guarantee, Le'emush Mibichov, that we have a guarantee. The Torah will never cease. We have a guarantee that it should happen again. To the contrary, historian viewing this difficult moment in time was regarded as an ever-present possibility. Many nations near and far seek to destroy us utterly, while other nations would stand by and watch. We're not living through that. Many nations would seek to destroy us utterly. That's the charter of the Hamas. The charter is to destroy yourself. And other nations will stand by and watch. That's what they're doing. If you defend yourself, oh no, God is not allowed to defend themselves. A student of the past can only conclude that there is a real danger in the future as well. Then can we be sure that we are secure in this world? With the realization, he concludes the safer with this, that we are safe solely to the extent that Hashem wills it and protects us. When we have the realization to the extent that Hashem wills it and protects us, that's how secure we are, then we have to know the God of Israel will never allow his holy nation, his beloved children of Israel, to utterly perish. We have to know that, that Klal Yisrael, he has many strong ability to speak about how the beloved nation of Kadosh Baruch Hu loves us. We are here, as promised. The Torah has never departed from our bounds. Yet at the end of the matter, we must strive in each generation, ours included, to deserve that protection. We just have to deserve it. We have to deserve it. The choice has been set before us. It is Torah that preserves us and Torah that gives us life. May our love for each other and for God and His commandments ever increase, and may God rejoice in His works. This is how he finishes the Sefer. He says, Torah is going to give us security, Ahavas HaBriyas, loving each other, and Ahavas Hashem and Mitzvahs. That's our security. In other words, we're not secure in this world. That we're not secure. But Ribbono Shel Olam is making us not secure to Chav B'Matzin. That we need a Ahavas HaTorah, a Ahavas HaBriyas, and a Ahavas Hashem. And we need to be inspired. And that's our security. Each and every ma'isa of Adam that happens in Klal Yisrael, every tzara, is a ladder for this tachlis. Chazal make a gewaldig diuk. That's unbelievable. We have the Nevi'im, were ages ago. The Nevi'im were the Darius. Only the Nevi'im that were recorded were the ones that are the Gael of Isa, the ones that every generation needs. No, he still speaks to us. So Chazal say, Nachamu Nachamu Ami Yoimar Lekecha. Yoimar Lekecha is a Loshen Osset. Chanino Bar Papa Verbi Simen of Chanino Bar Papa Omar. Omu Yisrael Yishayim. Yishayim Rabbeinu. Toimar Shalei Bosa Lenachem Elo Yisai Ador Shechor Beis Amidish Biyomah. Maybe only coming to be Menachem that door that had the Chum Beis Amidosh. Omar lehem, b'chol ha'doyre is bossi lehenachem. No, I'm coming from all the generations. Yoimar lekechem, ein sivkan, ala Omar lekechem, ala Omar lekechem, ein sivkan, ala Yoimar lekechem. It doesn't say Omar lekechem, it says Yoimar lekechem. The Eivish that says to every generation nachem. What was the Hava Amina, Omru Yisrael, Yishaya, Yishaya Rabbeinu, Taima Shalei Basel, Anachim, Al Loise, Ador, Shechor, Beis Amidus, B'Yomov? Why did they think maybe it's only for that generation? I was thinking, not proportionate, because Chazal tell us. We've been saying, Dilemai Yitess, Nizbol Ozov, Elikim Bol, Goyim, Benach, Losevo, and Chazal asked, Mizmor the Asim of the Kim, oh boy. Kin al Asim me by a lay. It's not a Mizmor, it's not a song. Because I'll answer. Mizmor al Shafach Chamosa al Ezim al Avon. In order to preserve Klalish, he poured his wrath on the stones of the Beis HaMikdash. Yes, the Beis HaMikdash that was the cornerstone of our life, the Beis HaMikdash that was everything for us. But in order to preserve Klalish, all the Eivish had to destroy the Beis HaMikdash. And that was a Tevet, so Mizmor Ozel, the Gimor Goy Menach HaSecho. So maybe Klal Yisrael said to Yeshaya, maybe it's only for that generation. Those the ones who will have the Churban, Shavach, Hamas, and Zerabonim, nope! For them it's a Nechama. Nechama means comfort. Comfort means even what you suffered before, but I'm comforting you that it was all for the best. It's a comfort. It's a comfort. You don't have to feel so terrible about what I've done. Comfort is for something that had a tayalis. That door had, they needed a full base of English. What does it do with us? Every single generation. Whatever we go through, we're confident that it's all for the good. We're confident we believe by Buddha Shleba that the Baruch was doing it to preserve Klal Yisrael till Mashiach comes to be Lairas. The Kabbalists are Kabbalists for the sake of Klal Yisrael. They're hurtful, they're terrible, we forget, unfortunately, from day to day. But these are Kabbalists, to be Lairas Klal Yisrael. These are Kedoshim that are being, that are killed, Rahmanul Itzlan, in order that Klal Yisrael should be in the Sayyid. Yoimar Alikeichem. To comfort us and know that it's all for your good. And finally, we have an avodah to be the sayer. Every single person, make his own cheshbon nefesh, listen to speakers and don't give us ideas of what to be the sage of the Klal Yisrael. But to go away from Tisha B'Av, not the same. Clarity of thought. 1 second, where am I? What's my davening like? What's my learning like? What are my mitzvahs like? What's going on? Just going back to the next thing as soon as it's over, the war is over, I'm back to life. I forget about Mashiach. I forget about Chelo Beis Yisrael. What's happening? And to be inspired, no, I'm going to be stark in my avodah. And not to forget about it. I'm going to be stark to daven Chelo Beis Yisrael every Monday and Thursday. And every time we say till, even when the war is over. And I'm going to keep davening for Mashiach. And then it's a moed, it's a gemaldik day. And we've been saying much tillin. So I saw brought down over here from Chassidus Sefer, Pinchas Bukharitz Sefer, Tisha B'Av, Be'ez Sheyoshven Ala Oretz U'ez Rotzim Gadol. V'yachol Adam Lifol B'Tfilosoy L'Hashem Yisbarach Mashetzarach. Meaning is Lashem Tisha B'Av Be'ez Sheyoshven Ala Oretz U'ez Rotzim Gadol. It's a gewaltige Shastfila. I thought maybe like the Moilim give an announcement today, the baby is crying. The baby is crying for a mitzvah. Moil announces it's a gewaltige Shastfila. People should have in mind Choylim and Klal Yisrael. When Klal Yisrael is sitting on the floor crying, it's a gewaltige Shastfila. It's a cry of anguish. From Golos Hashchina, Ve'iga from Muchnias, that the Eishna has to do. Oynshim that he himself doesn't want to do, just to be Ma'iras. It's a Gevaldika cry. And we're going to cry with the kinnas, and we're going to be spoiled from the raid of the kinnas, of how far we've gotten, and we're going to be in the Sayyid. And we're going to be inspired to change our ways. That cry, the Gota Shemaim, it's a Gevaldika Matfila, how much Klal one can accomplish. To help this matzim and in general to have takanach, you will not be as good as Mary the Lady.
Which in the other case is Hina Yud Beis.